Okay, this is something that I see is an absolute truth, and how I explain this as a truth, and that how I could validate this thing as a truth, no matter who or what God you say you believe in, or like say whatever, whoever you say you believe in a God that has your back, along with mortal human friends who also have your back, right? And say that's why you got an upgrade in life, as an example here. All right, it's a fact that the God that you say you believe in, or say you want to believe in, and people both will give you a break or give you something to see what you do with it. And in knowing that, there are people out there that when they get something, whether it's from a God that they claim they believe in or people, their friends, they're assholes. Some of them are fucking assholes. They lose respect from their God and their friends because they continue to be assholes, and they continue to be forever oppressed, forever depressed, and forever victims. Boo-boo, wah-wah. And when they get an upgrade in life, even if it's a smaller one, still dwelling on what so-and-so or something, somebody or something did to them in somewhere else where it shouldn't be matter, to where it shouldn't matter. When instead they should be enjoying what's regarded as a victory. That a God or friends or people got their back when it's given to you by whoever you want to say given it to you. It is presumed, or I'm a firm believer, that when it's the break is given to you by friends or whatever God, you are expected to appreciate it and enjoy it. And have joy in it and consider it a victory over the said enemy instead of wah, wah, I'm oppressed, wanting to hold on to being oppressed and depressed, and holding on to that bullshit, being a drama king or a drama queen, when in reality. See, my hair, wind keeps blowing my hair. In reality, it really is a lesser evil to be overly gloating in your triumph. I mean, you can do that too much, but I argue that that's a lesser evil compared to being an asshole and being a victim. But you can be an asshole to, one extreme to another, either, you know what I mean? All right, for example, say you got an upgrade in life, say you got a big break. Maybe it isn't a real huge break, but even if it's somewhat small, it can be a hell of a break. And say you believe that whatever God you believe in, along with your friends, which got your God and those friends got your back, and that's maybe how you got the upgrade, right? Right? And I'm telling you how you can actually lose everything, lose your big break, and lose everything, lose respect for, lose your this respect that you have in the eyes of whatever God you believe in that says that gave you the break and those friends, right? Which, for example, the said break you have an upgrade in life, when it is given to you by whoever had your back, you are expected to appreciate it, have joy in it, and yeah, be enjoying it. It should be a celebration of victory over your enemies or whatever was holding you down. I mean, it should be considered a victory. and you should be grateful for it, and you should appreciate it. And I don't care if you're an atheist or whatever. I'm trying to say, if you're some secular humanist, that I particularly, if you want to get into the Sky Daddy argument with about if somebody has a problem with, say, you believe in, say, a Sky Daddy, or whether you're some pagan or you have an occult belief or whatever, and people that don't like those kind of beliefs. You also, I'm going to talk in parentheses, I'd be telling some of them people, if they want to pull the Sky Daddy card, I'll be like, well, as far as worldly authority, why should I give a fuck about your worldly authority? And say there's no Sky Daddy, no kind of pagan anything or occultist anything. Who made you authority, and what authority, by what authority are you? What worldly authority, communist daddy you believe in? But I digress here. There is I bring up that side of the tracks because I'm not implying either that you should worship and bow down to the mortal people who gave you a handout either. And matter of fact, I'm also making a case too where these people with victim status and all kind of people, I'm not picking on just one race here, certain people that are white too and have different kind of issues, that matter of fact, that side of the tracks will keep putting resources, other people's resources, into handing these people an upgrade, and they continue to fuck up and they keep coming back for them, and they be giving people these handouts out of spite. But I digress. But for some of us that don't believe in a worldly authority here, if you want to not lose your credibility when you tell people whatever God you believe in is responsible for delivering you from your enemies, and say you got this upgrade in life that is supposed to be a victory over your enemies, you can. And people do this too and lose their credibility and lose that upgrade this way too. I mean, you have some people that are Christian that don't like anything I'm saying because they don't like how I'm saying it, but there is some truth, you know, in this belief. For example, and I don't want to be repetitive here, anybody, whether it's some God you say you believe in and your friends, I'm a firm believer that anybody that had your back, whether you believe it's some God you believe in and friends, those friends and that God you say you believe in can indeed and will indeed turn its eyes away from you and see you as ungrateful, unappreciative, and offensive. Say, instead of enjoying that victory, you go and cry like a baby and keep looking for oppression, you know what I mean? Yeah, a lot of us had family members, you know, and even parents or whatever, that engage in that behavior, and they claim they believe in God and do just that. And that's the kind of shit that I tell my partner all the time, that, and she has her own people that she knows that are guilty of this. And they wonder why they fucking lose. Say, if you want to be one type of secular humanist and all that, you know, and say a theory, you can. Nobody wants to have the back of somebody that doesn't fucking appreciate it, except if you're one of them highly liberal people, which. There are liberals that literally are inside cult-like type religions that claim to believe in Jesus, that coddle every single addict, every single person with a behavior disorder, which enables them instead of bringing them up. And they have a tendency to be jealous of people like me and even some of you like, like you and call you selfish because you're doing better than they are, or maybe you might have been waved down the line, did something bad, or a one-time alcoholic or addict, and those people, other people, oh, they'll be jealous of you. That's another story. There's a total other video you could make about shit like that too, but anyway, I can take, you know, any example, you know, say you had enemies, you can have, you know, people that'll mass report you, and you can bring police into it as an example. Like if you feel like whether you're black or white, people are mass reporting, you say in an old neighborhood, people had police involved one time, and you listen to all these assholes that are totally defund the police and they want the local badasses in control, which the people that worship the local badasses will do the same fucking thing to you too. You know, you listen to other people's advice. Say you got an upgrade, it can be a new place in a new area. I mean, this is an example rather than making a long fucking ass video and I go totally off track, because you can have multiple subjects that you can make a hour long video about, giving you a ballpark. Anything, whether it's any kind of enemy, whether they mass report you to the police or mass report you to the local badasses, which can be somebody of the same race as you or the other race as you, did you some kind of wrong. And you get an upgrade in your life. You're away from that, or you're bumped up and you get an upgrade by the God you claim you believe in, that has your back and the friends. And instead of enjoying it, and in some cases it's totally normal to be gloating your victory, but you don't want to do that too much anyway, but there's an ungratefulness that your own God can turn on you and your friends when you decide to be a constant victim and you're in a new area and you be throwing around bullshit, like victim bullshit, like that your friends don't want to hear either. I mean, it can be about anything that did you wrong. When you don't have those problems anymore, like say you want, if you're one of them people that want to be a victim and want to be oppressed and want to have all these problems, instead of the person who maybe you can be guilty in a sense of overly bragging and overly gloating, and you can also have another thing that I don't want to go too on and on too much and make up, because it's going to be a separate long ass video. You can do too much gloating your victory and exaggerate your victory and exaggerate your valor too, which you can do a whole separate hour long video about an interpretation, which means in Christianity that pride cometh before the fall. And I digress here, but I'm going to say this, make this brief, I promise, that my interpretation of that pride cometh before the fall, without making this a long-ass video, without making a long-ass video separately about it, it could mean, say, you do too much of, instead of being the victim and being down and being unappreciative of the victory that was given to you out of aid of the friends and the God you say you believe in, and destroying the credibility of the God you say you believe in and your... Yeah, I mean, you could go the other route too and be too big in your head and say you have some true victories that really show. You can be a big bullshitter too and then over-exaggerate and get really big in your head. And well, like social media influencers do. Like you can have the religious, fanatically religious social media influencers, and the total opposite social media influencers that hate any idea of any God or authority that's acknowledgement of any thing from the great beyond, right? I'm bringing both of them sides up. They get bigger than their heads. And it has happened in the social media influencer both sides of the tracks and media influencers, they lose the credibility of their friend. They get all these supporters. After a while, you know, get too big in their head, and pride cometh before the fall. You know what I mean? Talk too much shit and exaggerate. Pretend to be something bigger than you are to exaggerate your victories or whatever to a point where it's so big, it's so exaggerated, it gets obvious. You know what I mean? I mean, there are some people too that will do the fake it before they make it. You know, there are people out there that fake it, maybe. I'm not telling people to fake it, but fake it before they make it to a point where, for example, by time people figured it out, they did make it because they see already the next step coming. Not totally advocating that, because you can fuck up that way too. But then there are some people that are faking it till they make it, right? And faking it real big, and you don't see one step there that you're already... You know what? The ones where people fake it before they make it, they know they're okay. They're already damn near there by the time people figure out they're there. But then if you fake it too much where you're not really, how do you know you are going to be really, really going to make it, you know, biting off more than you can chew? And people look into it and notice too, you know what I mean? You don't want to do that. I mean, well, anyway, I'm giving you this ballpark, because even saying that,